tomorrow.
Those names and addresses.
Phyllis Dale, 156 West 47th Street.
I'm the same as her.
I'm so excited.
Diane Lorimer, 333 Park Avenue. And I bet she gets a little behind in her rent.
You told her.
Well, look who's here. You remember Anne Riley.
Anytime, Annie.
Who could forget her? She only said no once, and then she didn't hear the question.
Hey, Ethel. It must have been awful hard on your mother not having any children.
All right, quiet. We're doing a show here. And anyone who doesn't want to be a part of it, the nearest bread line's around the corner. Anyone? That's what I thought. Mac, finish getting those names and addresses.
All right, let's have them.
Hey, you're looking for someone?
Oh, the dance director. I'm here to get you to the show.
Oh, well, you're a little late. They already picked the chorus. You should have been here at 10.
Well, I was, but it took me an hour to get enough courage to go through the stage door. You're not Mr. Marsh, are you?
Billy Lawler, one of Broadway's better tenors. Say, you must be new to show business.
Oh, I've had experience.
How many shows?
Any number of them.
Such as?
This would have been my first if they'd taken me.
I'd take you any day. How about lunch?
Oh, thank you, but I have to see the dance director.
Oh, well then dinner or lunch tomorrow.
Oh, that's very kind of you, but I must see the dance director.
I know a bundle of humanity. She's about so high. I'm nearly driven to insanity when she passes by. She's a sunny little honey, but oh so hard to kiss. I'll try to overcome her vanity, and then I'll tell her this.
I'm young and healthy, and you've got charms. It would really be a sin not to have you in my arms. I'm young and healthy, and so are you. what am I to do? If I could hate ya, I'd keep away. But that ain't my nature. I'm full of vitamin A. Say, well, say, kid, I have an idea. You're not gonna get Andy Lee to audition you unless he's got no choice. You do know the song, don't you?
Oh, of course I do.
Well, then go on, kid, get to it.
To what?
Your first notes on Broadway. What are you looking for?
Oh, my good luck scarf I wore when I was elected Miss Allentown and Miss Junior Elk and...
Come on, kid, sing!
I'm young and healthy, and you've got charms. It would really be a sin not to have you in my arms. I'm young and healthy, and so are you. When the moon is in the sky, tell me what am I to do? If
I keep away. But that ain't my nature, I'm full of vitamin A.
Say, I'm young and healthy, so let's be bold. In a year or two or three, maybe we will be too.
From the top, Oscar!
I'm young and healthy, and you've got charms. It would really be a sin not to have you in my arms.
Oscar, Oscar, hold it, hold it! I told you to sing.
Oh, it was my idea, Andy.
Oh, that's a pretty fresh idea. You beat it.
Oh, come on, Andy. Give her a break. She's great.
Hey, Andy. Mr. Marsh is here. I just saw his taxi pull up.
I got no time for breaks. Mr. Marsh is here. And I'm straight, so it's...
Oh, stay here. I'll talk to Julian myself.
Oh, I don't want to get him into trouble.
Said beat it.
Well, at least give me your name.
Oh, I'm so sorry.
What is that?
She was just trying to get into the line, boss.
Ours or Notre Dame's? All right, everybody, gather around and listen to me. Today we start work on a new show. You're going to rehearse 4 weeks and then try out in Atlantic City. You're going to work 12 hours a day, 7 days a week. You're going to dance till your feet fall off when you aren't able to stand up. But 5 weeks from now, Pretty Lady's going to be the best show this town's ever seen. You're on your way to glory at $32 a week, so whoever thinks he can't take it, better quit right now. No one? Good. Now take a half hour to get fitted for wigs and costumes, and then
let's get to work.
All right, kids, wigs are just from A, costumes are downstairs tomorrow. Let's do it, let's go!
Hey, someone left their purse on the piano!
Oh, hey, it must be her, the kid Andy threw out. Is there anything in it?
It looks like there's about 40 cents and a card. Peggy Sawyer, 145 Elm Street, Allentown, PA. Look, kid, you go to your fitting. I'll see that she gets it. Julian, that was a great speech. You won't regret a word of it. Pretty Ladies is the best show we've ever written.
And now with the greatest director on Broadway. Never mind the soft soaper. I need the show as much as you do.
Wall Street got you too?
Nah, you know what the old saying. There's a schmuck for every light on Broadway. I've given all I had to that glittering gold shop there, and well, it's been a heck of a ride. Sure, the crash got me down for the count, but I'm still Julian Marsh, and Pretty Lady's gonna put me back on the top. Well, let's talk about the cast.
Best in town. We have Billy Lawler as the tenor.
Me and Maggie for the comedy roles.
And Dorothy Brock in the lead.
It's Brock I'm worried about. Her last hit was 10 years ago.
I know, but we have to use her, Julian. She's got Abner Dillon in her back pocket.
And you know Dylan's kitty cars. He's agreed to put up the whole 100,000. She's the star, but she can't dance.
I know, but just... put a lot of girls around her and make her wave her arms. The public will never know the difference, Julian.
I don't know, Maggie.
Easy, Julian. Here she comes now. Dorothy
makes... Don't say a word. I want to do this myself. Mr. Marsh, ever since I was a tiny little girl and saw my first Julian Marsh show, I dreamed of the day when I might work with the King of Broadway. At last that day has come, and I am filled with pride, joy, and humility.
Thanks, Miss Brock. I'm feeling a bit full myself. Now, if you don't mind, I'd like to try you on one of the numbers.
Oh, now hold on, Mr. Marsh. Dorothy, don't have to try out. We already got a contract.
Mr. Dillon, what would I do without you? By the way, there were a few items you forgot to mention, so I wrote them in. Limousine, redecorated dressing room, private maid, and no problem about the salary. I simply added another zero.
Now, see here, Dorothy.
Of course, if there's any objection, I won't insist. We'll simply peddle our kitty cars, and you can go peddle your fish.
Miss Brock, you're not hearing me. I'd like to try you on one of the numbers to see if you can handle the role.
Mr. Marsh, if you're asking me to audition, I'm afraid the answer is no.
It's not an audition, Dorothy. Julian just wants to find out if it's in the right key.
Yeah. Try that new one we went over yesterday. Dorothy, you are going to love it.
See Bert and I see in this line. Low down dive while the piano pounds out a hot jazz beat.
You'll enter and sing.
Shadows on the wall. I can see them fall. Here and there. Everywhere. Silhouettes in blue. Down.
That's fine, Maggie. Maggie! That'll do. Thank you. Oscar, try in 3/4 time for Miss Brock.
Julian, we've heard...
And down a tone. From the top, Miss Brock.
I'm sorry, Mr. Marsh, but...
From the top, Miss Brock.
Shadows on the wall. I can see them fall. Here and there, everywhere, silhouettes in blue, dancing in the dew. Here am I, where are you?
That's fine, thank you. Frankie, see if you've got a scrim on 28. Bring it in. All right, Oscar, top of the chorus, nice and easy. Kill the work lights. Miss Brock, if you'd please.
In the shadows, let me come and sing.
That's fine. Face front.
To you. Let me dream a song that I can sing. Gotcha!
I've got you. Look behind you.
Take me in your arms and let me cling to you. Let me live my song. Ooh, live my soul. In the winter, let me bring the spring to you. Let me feel that I mean everything to you. Love's old song will be new. In the shadows when I come and sing. In the shadows when I come and sing. In the shadows, in the shadows, in the shadows.
Thank you.
winter, let me bring the spring to you. Let me feel that I mean everything to you. Love's old song will be new. The shadows when I come and sing.
That was a compliment, Miss Brock.
Wardrobe, where are you? How do you expect me to dance when these sleeves are halfway to the ground?
Hey, kid.
Pat, what are you doing here?
I was in town seeing some booking agents. I figured I'd drop by to see my best girl.
And what if Mr. Dillon had been here?
What?
No, Pat, it's too dangerous. Now, I'm going and taking a picture or something.
Dorothy, I can't take your money. It was all right back when we had our act in vaudeville, but now you're a star.
What difference does that make if we still care for each other? Don't you think I hate being in corners like this? But isn't it better than not meeting at all? In the winter, let me bring the spring to you. Let me feel that I mean everything to you. Now run along, my dearest, and I will meet you in my dressing room at 5.
Still intact.
Thank you.
Miss Jones. Maggie Jones. Say, you look like you could use some grub. How about strapping on the feed bag for me and the girls?
Oh, I don't think I can.
Oh, I'd love if you would. I insist.
Oh. Hey, kid, I've been looking for you. How about lunch?
I would love to.
That's Peggy.
I'm sorry. I just promised to eat with Miss Jones and the girls.
Now, would you like to join us?
Oh, no, thank you. I'm looking for a mouthful, not an earful. But that's okay. I'll let you have a rain check.
What makes tenors such wolves?
No!
That's what makes them tenors. Now, come on, girls, we're taking that lovely place with the windows.
The Astroroot!
The Automat. Okay, fine, the gypsy tea kettle, but you're dancing to your way over there because I'm not wasting any time.
Oh, but I don't know your steps.
Oh, well, I think you can pick it up. I'll show it to you.
Okay.
Okay. Now with the pullback.
Dorothy Brown. I understand how she feels.
My grandmother felt the same way.
You can say that about Dorothy. In her first year, she made $30 a week and somehow sold $100 to her mother.
Let's face it, the only thing she has above anyone at this table is abnutilate.
Who's he?
Her sugar daddy.
Oh, her father. Oh, you can't be, just 21. A girl can't get that dumb in just 21 years.
Hey, we better teach you the Broadway facts of life, or you're never gonna make it.
Well, don't worry about me. I learned all about men in Allentown.
Oh, Gene O'Neill would have given his eye to the camera in that line.
Oh, should we tell her about the musicians?
Oh, please, Paul, maybe you need to know about the musicians is that we keep them in a pit, and it's for a good reason.
Oh, I still wish I were in the show with you.
Oh, you will be. Yeah, if not this one, the next. You're a looker. You can chirp like a bird. And you're pretty hot stuff in the stuff department, right? You hover some of the luckiest ones in the whole darn business. So what if you had a bit of bad luck this AM? It's got all your nutrients up, right there, and your angles. If you've a melancholy case of the blues,
until you learn how to sing a new song, go into your dance. Do some framing, learn how to smile.
Knocking my brains to put on a show they'll pay good money to see. And you're giving it away for free on the streets.
Oh, we didn't want me.
Now you kids get back in there.
Annie!
Oh, well, this is just great.
Is there something wrong, boss?
Wrong. We're short one girl, that's what's wrong.
But you told me to pick 24.
Plus one for good measure. I always pick one for good measure. Now don't give me any more of your excuses. Just get me another girl.
I can have one here by morning.
Oh, that's just ducky. I can hardly wait. And I'm supposed to set the boardwalk number this afternoon. You know, I've got a good mind to pick up the first girl I see on the street. Just go up to the first dame that passes you and say, you.
Who, me?
Yeah, you. Can you dance?
I'm from Allentown, Pennsylvania, and I can do any tap step ever invented. Wings, crab rolls, buffaloes, shuffles!
All right, take it easy, Allentown. You've got the job. Andy, take her in there and get her ready to rehearse. Oh. Hey, wait a minute. Aren't you the Mack truck who tried to run me down earlier?
Oh, I'm so sorry. I didn't realize it was you. It'll never happen again. I swear on my mother, my father, my sister.
Okay, take it easy, kid. Now get in there and start learning those routines. We've got a show to do.
Thank you, Mr. Marsh.
And Mac, did you get those kids in a costume?
Yeah, boss.
All right, now get me Brock and Billy. I want to run the boardwalk number with the dialogue.
We can't do the dance section, Mr. Marsh. Got to start with a cold.
Now then use Winnie.
No, you cannot use Winnie. She's already in the number. She'll never make the change.
Then get me any girl. We'll put a costume on her later. I want to run this number right now. Brock, Billy, let's go. It's morning. The sun shines brightly on a section of the Atlantic City boardwalk as we discover Rodney and Madeline. Madeline speaks.
Darling, darling, why do you take so long to declare yourself? The answer is yes, of course. And we'll live together in a cottage by the sea, and every morning we'll have breakfast and kisses in bed.
And Rodney says,
and will you always love me, Madeline?
Yes, 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 yes. Yes.
Now Rodney declares his love and they kiss.
Whoa, now hold on a minute. What is that fella doing to Dorothy?
It's just acting.
Oh, I don't care what you call it. I ain't putting up good money to see the woman I love kissed by no actor.
All right, cut the kiss. Just say the speech and improvise something.
Oh, my darling. I love you. I worship you. I adore you.
I don't know exactly how it started, but it started in fun. I just wanted someone to be gay with, to play with someone. But now I realize that I could never let you go, and I've come to tell you so.
Last section before the pivot.
All right, Oscar. Last section before the pivot. come on in. Set her down easy.
What happened?
One of the kids fainted. Par for the course on a Julian Marsh show. Get her some water, will you? And you better get back out there before the boss starts yelling for you.
Oh, all right. When she comes to, tell her I'll be back as soon as I get a break. The name's Lawler. Billy Lawler!
Yeah, come on, Billy.
You all right? Yeah, good guess.
But I guess I'm all right now.
Oh, bad guess. Now, let me be the doctor for a while. What you need is some rest.
Well, the rehearsal isn't over.
Oh, yes it is. For you anyways, young lady. Now, as your doctor, my first prescription is for you to sit on this chase.
But the rehearsal, I
and
really...
And as your second prescription, I want you to get those legs up.
And I'll bet I know what your third prescription is.
Dorothy, I wasn't expecting you till 5.
It's quite obvious you weren't expecting me, Doctor.
Darling, she fainted and they brought her in here till she came to.
And since when is my room an emergency ward for every clumsy Corrine who throws a little fainting act?
Miss Brock!
I'll get her out of here before I prescribe some medication she won't like so much.
Miss Brock, I...
You! Shut up! And if my prescription upsets you, Doctor, you can just get out with her!
What is going on in here? I'm trying to conduct a rehearsal on that stage. And who are you?
Pat Denning, Mr. Marsh. I was a guest of Miss Brock's.
Yeah, well, beat it. Miss Brock's official gentleman friend happens to be in the house, and, well, I wouldn't want him to get any funny ideas.
Dorothy!
Pat, quick, behind the chase, it's Abner!
You stay right where you are. Come right in, Mr. Dillon. We were just having a little script conference.
Dorothy, I got these posies for you.
Thank you.
Dorothy. Oh, I hope I wasn't interrupting anything now.
Oh, no, not at all. We were just winding up. By the way, this is one of our dancers, Peggy Sawyer, and her boyfriend, Pat Denning.
Now, just a moment,
say,
Julian.
Mr. Dillon. Do you realize it's your fault that this conference is breaking up?
Oh, my fault?
That's right. Miss Brock said she didn't want to discuss the script any further because, well, she wanted to be alone with you.
Do you mean that, Dorothy?
Of course I mean it. What girl wouldn't want to be alone with you? Just look at yourself.
Mr. Denning. Your presence in this dressing room has caused a great deal of unnecessary turmoil, and I suggest such visits do not occur again. Oh, and another thing. This kid's a pretty good hoofer, and I don't want to lose her for the price of a bowl of chili. Take her out and get her something to eat. Miss Brock, may I have a word with you, please?
Of course, Julian. Is it about the character you're playing?
No, it's about the character you're playing around with. Now, I don't know what went on in there, but Pretty Lady means far too much to me to let any gigolo stand in its way. I want you to give him up.
Aren't you a bit confused, Julian? You're the director of my show, not my personal life.
When your personal life gets in the way of my show, I direct that as well.
Mr. Marsh, I shall see whom I please, when I please, and no show is going to stand in my way.
Bert, I think we've got ourselves a little problem. And I think I've got myself a solution. Nick Murphy, please.
Murphy? He's a killer. Look, Julian, if you don't like the song, just say so.
I put a girlfriend of his in my show once, and he owes me a favor. Hello, Nick. It's Julian. I'm calling you about a bit of a problem I'm having. You see, there's a fellow been hanging around my rehearsals by the name of Pat Denning, and I thought since your place is right next door, you could send a couple of boys over to persuade himself to make him scarce for the next few weeks. Right. All right, Nick, it's a pleasure doing business with you. And that, I believe, is the end of that.
Julian!
Oh, what's our problem? Atlantic City just told us they canceled our booking. But it's okay, because we just got the week at the RC Theater and it's filling up!
But all of our shows have opened in Atlantic City!
Maybe Phil, you'll change your luck.
He's right. All right.
Grabbing my hat.
I came in the hat of the monster.
They told me a fairy
boat
getting out of town.
I'm sorry I couldn't take you any place fancier, but the old blue strings are a bit frayed at the moment.
Hey, no guy named Pat Denning?
Yes, actually.
Well, he got a message for me. You better lay off this brat thing, or it's gonna be too bad for him. You get it?
I'll tell him.
Yeah, it's just like you don't forget. Peace.
Some friends, with good advice. You're with the company? I'd like to leave a message for Miss Dorothy Brock. Hello, that Pat Denny has joined a stock company in Philadelphia and will be gone, say, 6 months with no forwarding address. I'm shining my traveling shoes, big scoop in the Daily News. Who's saying this to the loo's getting out of town?
I don't want to go to Philadelphia. My contract says I must stay out of town in Atlantic City.
But Dorothy, why don't you want to go to Philadelphia?
Who says I don't want to go to Philadelphia? I want to go to Philadelphia. My contract says I must stay out of town in Philadelphia.
So let's get moving.
My neighbors are awful nice. They call Mr. Favorite Lies. Hey, Iceman, don't need your eyes getting out of town. Here's my they're going by my we're shouting hurrah. Rain's ready, cause we're ready for cha cha cha.
But it's up to you to see that we get out of here alive. There are 25 musicians in that pit just dying to go on overtime, so let's get this dress rehearsal started. Oh, and another thing. Not all of the costumes and set pieces have arrived yet, so we'll be adding things as we go. Don't let it throw you. Professor, we're late. Let's get going.
All right, Max.
Oh,
Too good. Mr. Marsh, I am the star of the show, and I do not appreciate you making my entrance 10 seconds before the blackout!
Are you suggesting I bring you on after the blackout?
I'm suggesting you redo the dance to suit my talents.
I'm afraid that might make it a rather short number.
You'll regret that remark, Mr. Marsh. You may be the director of the show, but I am driving the kiddie car.
All right, the rest of you. You've earned it. So I want you to go out and forget all about Pretty Lady until tomorrow. Then, I want you to come back here and give the performance of your lives. Company dismissed.
Company dismissed!
Company dismissed!
Oh, Diane, I want everything on a hanger, nothing on the floor. Everything on a hanger. Harvey, I want to work on those spot cues.
I'm going to finish getting changed, Peggy, and meet you at the stage door.
I'll see you in a minute, Billy. Mr. Marsh! Are you going to the Regency Club? Miss Jones and Mr. Barry invited everyone. Something funny?
You are. Eyes shining like a kid at Christmas. Dreaming of parties and opening nights. The tinsel and glitter of musical comedy. Just look at yourself. A speck of dust on that stage, indistinguishable from 40 other specks of dust that I put there.
I know that, Mr. Marsh, but put all those specks together and you have something alive and beautiful. Reach 1,000 people we've never even seen before.
Broadway dreams, Sawyer. We've all had them.
Well, I mean to hold on to mine, Mr. Marsh.
So did I. Sweet dreams, kid.
They are. I'm a speck of dust in your show.
Andy! Andy, where are you?
Right here, boss.
Got all 7 pages of those notes typed out.
All right, the notes can wait. I've decided to take some of my own advice and forget all about Pretty Lady until tomorrow.
Boss.
Now, come on. I hear Jones and Barry are throwing a party at the Regency Club. Let's go dream a bit.
Tomorrow. Not with Dorothy Brock. She's out of the show!
Wrong. Brock opens tomorrow as scheduled. Don't be a fool, Dylan. You're going to throw away all that money because of the dames?
It's my funeral, ain't it?
Yeah. And the funeral of 50 other kids who've been dancing their feet off to give you a show you could be proud of. Are you going to put them on the street, too?
Well, Mr. Dylan, you wouldn't do that, would you? Not if we put all our faith in you.
But she called me a cobra and a beached whale!
Listen, in show business, that's a compliment. But she needs just a little bit of fun, so I'll take you to a quiet corner and sing you the songs from my last 6 shows. I don't care how many hotels you've tried. Try the Bell with you too, and now.
I don't know what's gotten into her. She was fine this afternoon. I smell a rat, Bert. And the rat's initials? They're Pat Denny.
Hello, Belvedere. Have you a Pat Denning there? You do? Well, give it to me, you idiot!
Hey, boss. It's Florence.
She's
in
Opalmont.
Told me Dorothy Brock
flew
in all over town for Pat Denning.
So I was right. Denning is in town.
Oh, Pat, darling. I can't take it anymore. I've tried to forget you, but I can't So please come back at once. At once.
Hey, Peggy. How about the next dance?
In a minute, Billy.
What are you going to do about that, boss? I'm going to call Nick Murphy. I think he's got a couple of Philadelphia cousins who might be able to handle the situation.
Oh, Pat, darling!
Dorothy, calm down. Tell me what's wrong.
I can't take it anymore. I'll tell you in a minute. Just hold me, and I'll let go.
All right, it's all set. A couple of the boys will be over in 10 minutes, and they'd better not find Denny here. Hey, Peggy, how about that dance now?
Oh, I'm sorry, Billy. A friend of mine's in trouble.
A man friend or a lady friend?
A man, but...
It's all right. I get it. Good night, Peggy.
Oh, Billy.
Something the matter, Billy?
Not anymore. Come on, let's have some fun.
Miss Brock... It's me, Peggy Sawyer.
Aren't you that fainting violet Mr. Denny took out to dinner last week?
Oh, Pat, I have to tell you something. There's going to be trouble.
You're darn right there is. Unless you get out of here.
Wait a minute, Dorothy. Now, Peggy, what is it?
Two men, friends of Murphy's.
Don't tell me to wait a minute. And how come you're standing up for her in the first place?
You don't understand.
I think I understand all too well.
You don't.
Get out of here, the both of you.
Well, Miss Brock!
It's all right, baby. Well, Dorothy, if you could just give me the time of day.
Besides the both of you.
If that's the way you want it.
That is the way I want it. Get out! Out, out!
Disappear from your
the best out-of-town opening we've ever had. They love it.
Yeah, but they won't love it for long unless we can speed up these changes.
Mac! Where's that cue?
Come in, Mr. Marsh. Just wait for the girls to get in position.
All right, here they are.
All right, Q64, go!
You got it?
I got it! Now pull it up! We gotta wait for the golf stick! It's stuck up here before it falls off!
Watch out for the subway train!
I got it! What is it, a penny?
A nickel!
Hold your horses, let me get the dirt off. A dime! We're in the money! We're in the money!
Unless Brock gets out here. Dorothy, where are you?
There's no need to
Dr. Sharp, student, I can hear you.
All right, you're on in about 10 seconds.
I have never missed a cue in my life. When I do, you can take me to task, not before. Miss Brock, I wanted to explain about last night. I don't want an explanation. Miss Brock, get away from me! The further the better!
Quiet! You're on.
I accuse you of the 8. Go!
Your tickets will be refunded at the box office. House lights.
The show is closing!
Good job!
I can't pay my rent! I'm broke!
one.
That sort of style takes years of experience to develop.
Unless the kid's got it naturally, which she just might have. Julian!
Do you know how many pages she'd have to learn? Not to mention the songs and routines.
She's young. Kids can do anything. You could put the dancing back to the show, boss. Come on, Julian, it's worth a try, isn't it?
All right, send her in.
There's just one problem. You just fired her.
But it may not be too late to get her back. She's taking the 1110 to Allentown. Gives you 20 minutes to get down to Broad Street Station.
What do we do, boss?
Get her off that train. I want Sawyer in New York by 8:30 tomorrow night, ready to work.
Hold on, Mr. Marsh. Won't we stay here in Philadelphia?
And lose $10,000 a night? Our only chance is to ship the show to New York, beat the party to her in 36 hours, and open the call on Thursday.
36 hours.
Now get going!
Wait a minute!
This is my job. I fired her. It's up to me to get her back.
Julian! I can go.
I said I'll do it. Thank you, Miss Riley. You may have just done me quite a favor.
Anytime, Mr. Marsh. Anytime.
All right, so we'll give about 15 minutes to try and convince her then.
We'll bring in the big guy.
Not easy, but I got the message loud and clear. Go back to where you came from, Miss Peggy Sawyer. And that's just what I'm going to do.
Miss Sawyer, I'm here to apologize and to ask you to come back.
I have a train to catch, Mr. Marsh.
And to take over Dorothy Brock's role in Pretty Lady. Her ankle's broken and she's out of the show. If you can do it, the part's yours.
I'm sorry, Mr. Marsh. Show business isn't for me. I'm going back to Allentown.
What's that word you just said? Allentown? I'm offering you the chance to star in the biggest show Broadway's seen in 20 years, and you say Allentown. Now listen, Sawyer, and listen good. Even if you don't care about me, think of all the kids you'll be putting out of work if you don't do this. Think of the songs that will wither and die if you don't get up there and sing them. Think of the scenery that will never be seen, the costumes never worn, the orchestrations never heard. Think of Pretty Lady and the thrill and pleasure it could give to millions. Think of musical comedy, the most glorious words in the English language. Sawyer, think of Broadway. Come on along and listen to the lullaby of Broadway. The hidey-hi, the whoop-dee-doo. The lullaby of Broadway. The rumble of a subway train. The rattle of the taxis, the
daffodils who entertain, and Angelos and Maxis when a Broadway baby says goodnight. It's early in the morning. Manhattan babies don't sleep tight. Well, until the
you. Hey.
Sawyer, Pretty Lady opens on this stage in exactly 36 hours. You have 25 pages, 6 songs, and 10 dance routines to learn before 8:30 tomorrow night. Do you think you can do it? Do you think you can do it, Sawyer?
Yes, Miss Marsh,
I can! Begin. Matt, Gosher, where's the piano? Anthony, come on. All right, everybody, we're going to start with the opening number, then we're going to work the songs and dances, then go back and do the scenes. There'll be a 5-minute break every hour for food or coffee, and a full 15 minutes every 4 hours for rest. And no one else on this stage until I say so.
All right, everybody, clear the stage, let's go!
By tomorrow, we'll either have a leading lady or a dead chorus girl. What are you waiting for? Let's begin.
All right, Peggy, follow Billy's lead.
Sharper, Sawyer.
Thank you.
What's wrong?
They've just called half hours. Is it time for this?
Sorry. I know how tough it must be.
Do you? I'm not so sure.
You wearing my costumes, singing my songs, playing my role? I wanted to hate you. I wanted to see you fail. But sitting there and watching you rehearse, I found I couldn't hate you. Because you're good. Maybe even better than I would have been. The public wants youth, freshness, beauty. And Peggy, that's what you've got. Only I'm getting something too. For 10 years, theater's kept me from the only thing I've ever wanted. And it took a broken ankle to finally help me realize it. Pat Denning and I were married this morning.
Oh, Miss Brock.
Oh, there's only one last thing for you, my dear. You have to take it easy. Let the audience come to you. Is that what I mean?
I would appreciate it very much.
Dorothy.
Kid, and show what we can do. Oh, Annie, Gladys, Lolly, Phil, I'll
I promise.
Your best? That's not good enough. I want better than your best. I want sheer, unadulterated brilliance. Now, what are you kids hanging around for? Get into your places for the opening.
Oh,
Peggy, I want to talk to you.
Julian, it's 8:40. We've got to begin.
They've waited this long. They can wait another minute. Now listen, Sawyer, and listen hard. 100 people, 100 jobs, $100,000, 5 weeks of blood and sweat and grind, and it all comes down to what you do out there tonight. Now, I know what you're thinking. Here comes Marsh with another one of his pep talks. Well, this is the last of them, Sawyer. And it comes straight from the heart. Our hopes, our futures, our lives are in your hands. Go out there and make them shine with your golden talent. This afternoon it was acting. This one, I mean.
William? Gotta start.
All right, tell him to take the house to half. Sawyer, you're going out there a youngster, but you've got to come back a star.
Bye.
will do the rest of the show, and without any mistakes, and without that thing either. I'm Julian Marsh, and I say you will.
Their glorified. Shop that comes home a winner. For years to come, thousands of little chorus girls will go to auditions saying to themselves, who knows, I might come out of this another Peggy Sawyer. The only thing I ask is that you be the sort of star those girls would want you to be. Shine your light over this glorious gulch we call 42nd Street. Give it your talent, your strength, your youth, but try, if you can, not to give it all your heart. Because it's a very loving heart, I would never want to see it broken. Now run along to the Ritz and enjoy yourself.
Good night, Miss Marsh.
Good night, Allentown. Say, where is the kids' party?
At Lorraine's. The address is on the call board. And Mr. Marsh, it would be grand, grand, grand if he would come.
Hey, Peggy, you ready?
Yes, Billy, I'm ready now.
Come and meet those dancing feet on the avenue I'm taking you to, 42nd Street. Hear the beat of dancing feet. It's the song I love, the of 42nd Street. Little nifties from the 50s, innocent and sweet. Sexy ladies from the 80s who are